Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Live at the Whiskey Lounge. My name is Steve Rashid, and I am thrilled. I was just saying, you know, it's a holiday weekend, and it just started occurring to me this afternoon as everybody was saying, oh, I'm off tomorrow. I was like, geez, I hope anybody's still left in town here and willing to come out. So thanks so much for coming out and supporting live jazz here anywhere, but particularly here this evening. And let me be among the first to wish you a happy 4th of July weekend. We do this every Thursday. By the way, they're doing some construction downstairs, so the welders will be coming up a little later, putting on a fireworks show for us. So we're all set. We do this every Thursday. I am a musician myself, and I was down playing on the stage downstairs about a year and a half ago, and saw this beautiful room and thought, gosh, what a beautiful room for jazz. So I talked to the management, and sure enough, they were amenable. So we started doing this in March of 2014, and this is close to our 70th show now. So we do a lot of shows, and it's something a little bit different every week. The whole idea is duets and trios. So small group jazz, small ensemble, very conversational. I like that, and I like the intimacy of this room and how close people can get. So I think you're in for a real treat tonight with these fine gentlemen. I come up at the end of the first set, and we do a little bit of a Q&A with these guys and get to know them a little better and invite your questions as well. So you're welcome to chime in there. We do treat this as a listening room. So just so you're aware of that, these are like little miniature concerts, and we do appreciate your attention. We do, as you can see, there looks like a lot of technology up here. We have a lot of microphones. We do a live recording of every show, just the way we would do in the recording studio. I have a live rig over there, and we do a live multi-track recording. And then these little guys are cameras. We got five of these cameras around here. And my buddy Carl Ross, who I'm very grateful for, is over here handling the video end of things. And so we do a live stream. You have these little cards on your table. You're welcome to take those with you. It gives you a rundown of who's coming up in the coming weeks. And there's a website on there. You can go to the website and you can stream our shows if you can't be here on a particular week. Or if you want to see a show again afterwards, you can log in and see them on the archive. All of our shows are archived up there. I'm starting to run out of things to say. I'm going to bring these fellows up in a second. By the way, I'm here next week. I started this series as a place where I could play, and it's getting harder and harder for me to find the spot for myself. So I'm stealing a week back myself and coming here with my trio with Don Sternberg and Jim Cox. So that should be fun for us. But tonight, you're in for a real treat. It's Bill Overton. Bill was here almost exactly a year ago, I think, with Don Sternberg doing a traditional jazz night here. And it was really, really fun. This is going to be something a little bit more modern than that. And he's here with two fantastic players, Jeremy Kahn on the piano and Larry Kohut on the bass. All extraordinary musicians with really storied careers. And so we'll have a fun time chatting with them a little later and finding out some stories about what they've been doing lately and some of their influences and all that kind of stuff. But for now, I'm going to step out of the way. Thank you for your kind attention. And let's give it up for Bill Overton, Jeremy Kahn, Larry Kohut. I forgot to tell you, this is what the stream looks like. We're live right now. How about that? Yeah, wave. Thank you.
Thank you very much. That was a Chano Pozo tune that Dizzy Gillespie used to like to play called Ten Ten Deo. A lot of fun to blow over. We're going to do a tune, Rue Bloom tune, for you now called Ruby.
They say
moving like a dream, not always what you see. And though my heart will break when I awake, let it be snow, I only know, Ruby, it's you. They say that Ruby, you're like a song, and you don't know right from wrong. And in your eyes I see heartache for me, but from the start I only know, Ruby, it's you. I hear your voice and I must come to you. I have no choice, what else can I do? And they say that Ruby, you're like a flame, into my life you came. And though I should be where, still I don't care, you thrill me so, Ruby, I know, Ruby, it's you. We're going to do a great old tune for you that is not played too much. It's called I'm Coming to Virginia. You know that one? Thank you. Thank you. Thanks very much. Jeremy and Larry and I had a gig at Andy's Jazz Club for almost a year last year, and that was such a great time. We had a lot of fun and explored a lot of tunes, you know, learned a lot of stuff, and which is really a lot of fun. Duke Ellington always, people would ask him what his favorite composition out of the 1,000 or how many ever he wrote, and he would always say the next one. You know, so that's kind of the way it is with, you know, the way I look at music. I mean, the next tune that you learn is really the most fun. So we had a lot of fun learning new stuff. We're going to do a Mel Torme tune now for you. That's called Born to be Blue. Something like that, maybe the last 8 bars.
Page 2, 1, 2, 3.
Were meant to live in clover. Oh, but they are such a chosen few. 'Cause clover being green is something I've never seen. 'Cause I was born to be blue. And when there's a yellow moon above me, they say that there's moonbeams that I should view. But moonbeams being gold, that's something I can't behold. Oh, 'cause I was born to be blue. Now when I met you, baby, you know the world was bright and sunny. And when you left that curtain fell, I'd like to laugh, but nothing strikes me funny. Now my world is just a faded pastel. Well, I guess I'm luckier than some folks, 'cause I've known the thrill of loving you. That alone is more I was created for. Yeah, 'cause I was born to be blue. Thank you. sunny. And when you left that curtain I'd like to laugh, but nothing strikes me funny. Cause now my world is just a faded pastel. Well, I guess I'm luckier than some folks. Yeah, would I say that there's moonbeams I should view? But that alone is more than I was created for. Yeah, cause I was born to be blue. Mel Torme. We're going to do a Charlie Parker tune for you right now. It's always good to throw in a little Charlie Parker. And this is called Moose the Mooch, based on I Got Rhythm. Thank you. something like that.
Yeah.
Thank you. You're very kind. Very kind. We're having a lot of fun, obviously, up here playing, and we hope you're having fun, too. That's the whole point, isn't it? Yeah, so that's why we're all here. Wow, we really appreciate you guys coming out on a holiday weeknight. Man, oh, man, this is great. This is fabulous. We can't think of a place I'd rather be than right here. So we're going to continue now with a song by a fellow named Jerome, looks like Morose. Jerome Morose, M-O-R-O-S-S. It's called Lazy Afternoon, and it's from a show, and I think it was the only tune that came out of this show that ran for just a little bit, it was just one of those things that somebody recorded this and it kind of caught on a little bit. But it's a really pretty tune, and we hope you like it. I'm going to play alto flute on this in case you're wondering what this weird curved instrument is, so hope you like it. Lazy Afternoon. For a weird, crazy person.
Yeah.
Old grandpa can't see no more. Gotta raise the stand a little bit. Just give me a little G minor up front. That's what we're in.
I do that one.
A one, a two, and a one, two, three, and. It's a lazy afternoon, and the beetle bugs are zooming, and the tulip trees are blooming, and there's not another human in view but us two. It's a lazy afternoon, and the farmer leaves his reaping, and the meadow cows are sleeping. Speckled trout stop leaping upstream as we dream. A fat pink cloud hangs over the hill, unfolding like a rose. If you hold my hand and sit real still, you can hear the grass as it grows. It's a lazy afternoon, and I know a place that's quiet. Days is running riot, there's no one passing by to see. Come spend this lazy afternoon with me. Thank you.
it's a lazy afternoon, and the beetle bugs are zooming, and the tulip trees are blooming, and there's not another human in view, just us two. It's a lazy afternoon, and the farmer leaves his reaping, and the meadow cows are sleeping, and the speckled trout stop leaping upstream as we dream. A fat pink cloud hangs over the hill, folding like a rose. If you hold my hand, then sit real still, you can hear the grass as it grows. It's a lazy afternoon, and I know a place that's quiet, except for daisies running riot, and there's no one passing by to see. Come spend this lazy afternoon with me.
Thank you. Lazy afternoon. I'm going to continue now with a Joe Beam tune called Triste.
What key?
Two flats.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks so much.
They love you, man.
Well, they love you.
No, they love you.
No, they love you more. It's just a love fest. That's all it is. Boy, as I said, we're really having a great time. Man, this is great. We're going to do a song now that with the music by a fellow named Oscar Levant. Oscar Levant. If you know who Oscar Levant was, he was quite a character and raconteur, worth looking up, worth Wikipediaing. He was really, really something. Also a concert-level pianist and composer, and liked to hang out with the Marx Brothers a lot. Because he could evidently just sort of go from house to house back in the Gilded Age and just sort of stay with them. But he was quite a character and really an amazing guy. But he wrote this tune called Blame It on My Youth, so we're going to do this for you.
Can we do this now? Is that cool?
Of course we can.
Okay.
Sure.
If I expected love when first we kissed, blame it on my youth. If only just for you did I exist, blame it on my youth. 'Cause I believed in everything, just like a child of three, and you meant more than anything. All the world to me, and if you were on my mind night and day, blame it on my youth. And if I forgot to eat and sleep and pray, blame it on my youth. And if I cried just a little bit when first I learned the truth, don't blame it on my heart, blame it on my you. If you were on my mind, both night and day, blame it on my youth. And if I forgot to eat and sleep and pray, blame it on my youth. And if I cry a little bit when first I learned the truth, don't blame it on my heart, blame it on
thank you. Thank you so much. You're very kind. Obviously, you know, like I said, the next tune is always the most fun to learn. I don't care whether I feel like I can, you know, have the chops to tackle something or not. I just figure, well, look, you know, if they can't take a joke, you know. And so, but I mean, it's so much fun to do these tunes and explore things like that. And so that's what we're doing. We're just having fun playing. And we appreciate you listening very much. It means a lot to us. We're going to conclude this set. And by the way, we're here for certainly another set after a brief break and question and answer thing. And And we're going to conclude this set with a tune that's a little bit, it's not really jazz, it's kind of a little bit out of the realm of what we've been doing so far. But again, it's just a song that's really a favorite of mine by a fellow named Justin Townes Earl. I'll tell you just a little bit about, do you know Justin Townes Earl? I love Justin Townes Earl. He is the son, he's probably in his early 30s by now, I would say something like that, and great writer. I just feel like he's like the next Bob Dylan as far as the content of his writing, and he's just really something. And he is the son of Steve Earl, who is, of course, a great legendary songwriter. And Justin Townes Earl has quite a story, you know, in his life, but he's an amazing writer and musician. So we're going to just give us a second to strap on the guitar, and we're going to do one of Justin's tunes called Harlem River Blues. And again, thanks so much for coming out, and you better not leave. You better stay here. If you're curious, if this looks out of proportion a little bit, it's a baritone guitar. I had a regular Telecaster, and I took the neck off, and I put a longer neck on here, a baritone conversion neck is what they call it, and put heavier strings, and so you get this.
It's my headphone. What's happening?
Yeah.
Oh, I turned it.
That's what you get when.
First things first, baby.
Yeah, sorry. So you get that. It's just a lower pitch thing, so it's kind of nice. Anyway, here we go.
Sound.
of town, to the Harlem River to drown. Dirty water's gonna cover me over, and I'm not gonna make a sound. But I'm going uptown to the Harlem River to drown. Yeah. Dirty water's gonna cover me over, and I'm not gonna make a sound.
Justin Towns Earl, thank you. Jeremy Kahn, Larry Kohut.
Play the blues. How fun is this? That's Jeremy Kahn. There's Larry Kohut and B.B. Overton, Bill Overton. I'm gonna sneak in here. Pardon me while I wind my way through the crowd. Bill, I was thinking maybe if I stood sort of here, okay. You can have your mic and I can hand
it this way.
Excellent. You know, I always talk about how fun it is with a series to spotlight different eras of jazz. I mean, we have everything from something an evening of 1920 style jazz to stuff that's an evening of pure free improvisation and everything in between. And it feels like tonight we're almost getting a history of jazz in one evening. It's really great. Bill, you have, I tried to do a little bit of research on the guys before they come here, and you played with a million people. I mean, everybody from Doc Cheatham and Major Holley to Bo Diddley and the Temptations, and last weekend you were at Ravinia, right?
That's right.
Can you tell us about that?
Well, it was really interesting. They hired a big band horn section, mostly people from the Chicago Jazz Orchestra, to fill out the band for Tony Bennett and Lady Gaga. And it was, I had a great time, and I'll tell you something. I was a Lady Gaga fan before, and the thing is that I'm an even bigger fan now because I really enjoyed Lady Gaga, and the thing is she gets a lot of heat and a lot of criticism, of course, because she's trying something new. You know, and she's a pop star. She's Lady Gaga. You know, she's not Ella Fitzgerald. But she was very humble and paid tribute to Tony Bennett throughout the show and just said, oh, God, I'm learning so much and all that. And she was very nice to us. And like I said, I'm a real fan of hers.
That's cool. That's good to hear. How do you get a gig like that? I mean, does her brother Gary Gaga call you or what? What happens?
Well, I think just being sort of a working pro on the scene, I mean, I can double and read, and I play in big bands, play in Marianne May's big band sometimes, and play with the Chicago Jazz Orchestra. And just, I'm 61. I've been doing this since I was 10. So after a while, you sort of get some skills, I guess. But if you are kind of a working pro on the scene, you might get called for something like that if you're that kind of player. So
sure. So that's fantastic. Yeah. I wanted to comment on the alto flute. Mm. One of my favorite instruments. I'm always drawn to the darker wind instruments of flugelhorns and
me too.
And alto flute is so gorgeous. Is that something? Now, is that something is that a recent addition for you? Or have you been playing
pretty
it
recent? Time? Yeah, I mean, I would borrow one whenever I got hired to play one, and then finally, as an adult, I was able to accumulate a few hundred dollars, and so I bought one. I bought one for myself. But but they're also, it's kind of nice now because nowadays in modern times, with CAD CAM and all that, they can build really pretty good playing instruments for, you can buy them like for, a reasonable price. You don't have to mortgage your home to buy a flute nowadays. So I bought one and I'm having a great time with it.
Wow, well, it really sounds great.
Thank you.
I need to talk to these two guys too.
Need is such a strong word.
Need is a strong word. Larry, my old friend.
Yes.
You really are fantastic. It really is fun to hear you. Isn't he great? It's so melodic, so in the pocket, so solid and playful at the same time. It's really, really wonderful. And you've been doing a lot of work with Garrison Keillor, right?
Yes. And when you said Ravinia last week, I'm like, no, I was there last week. I guess that was 2 weeks.
Yeah, I'm going to give you them. Can you tell us a little bit about what you've been doing?
Oh, sure. I've been, I've had the great privilege, I guess, to be playing most of Prairie Home Companion last season. And actually, tomorrow, this weekend is the end of the season. We're off for a couple weeks, and then we go out for a five-week tour through July and August of the summer.
Wow. How did... we'll be sharing. they're based primarily in Minnesota, though. So are you traveling back and forth every week?
Yeah. In fact, we had a rehearsal yesterday at Garrison's house for the tour. So, yeah, I flew out to Minneapolis yesterday morning at 6:30, and I got home at 10 o'clock at night.
So you go there, rehearse, and then come back? And
just
back
for
to
that
one.
Yeah.
Wow.
But they're usually, sometimes they're there, they kind of, they go around the country in different places. It's a Friday morning to Sunday morning commitment sort of thing. It's great fun. I love doing it. Yeah.
Well, and now that you've heard him, you may have heard Larry here before. This is not the first time he's been here. He's been here several times. Yeah, I know. We had the great. I have had the great pleasure of playing with Larry, and so you understand why he would be called for a gig like that, right? And he, they bring him in from out of town. Hey, Jeremy.
Yes.
You know, I think you're right. I think that the time that I thought I met you was it wasn't you. And I wish I could remember. It was there's many, but there's another piano player in town that Jim plays with. We were trying to, Jeremy walked in the door and we were agreeing, well, he felt we had never met, and I was certain that we had met at some point, and now I'm thinking that you're probably right, because it was like 10 years ago that I remember meeting a guy that in retrospect I think is probably not, was Jeremy.
Did he look then like Jeremy looks now?
No, but he still owes me some money, so that's where I was kind of going with that.
So it probably was me.
It was you. You know, I do a little bit of research on these guys. You were a guest on Mary McPartland's Piano Jazz, and I listened to that episode. It's really cool. It's really cool. And that was, so can you tell us, and it... As you described, it was actually on your website, and as you described on your website how it happened, it was really kind of interesting because it sounded like, well, I'm not going to tell you what you did. You can tell people what you did, but it was a really interesting story, even how you got on the show. To me, that was an interesting story. Do you remember how you got on the show?
I'll make something.
All right, good. Tell us. It involved the circus. Go ahead.
Sure.
As I recall writing on my website, I'm sure I made it up, how did it happen?
You said you sent her...
Oh, yeah. I sent her a CD, but pretty much every piano player alive sends Marianne McPartland a CD, so I didn't really expect to hear back from her, but sure enough, my phone rang, and this very charming lady said, oh...
She called you.
She called me and said, oh, yes, I got your CD. It's lovely, and would you want to come and do the show? And I said, yes, I would. And she was extremely apologetic about the money. She said, well, it's really more of an honorarium than it is a stipend, or I don't know which words she used.
That's not how tonight works.
Yeah, right. Truth is, she curses worse than any sailor you've ever met. But she was turning on the charm on the phone, and I would have, you know, paid all sorts of money myself to go out there. So yeah, it was a tremendous honor. Just thinking of all the incredible people that she's had on her show, and to be included in that long roster was a tremendous honor. And we had a great time. Very, very nice woman. Very charming host. She bristled at the producer that was in the studio. Every time the producer would suggest something, she would look at me and kind of roll her eyes. I remember she ate a lot of soup, but I don't hold that against anyone. So.
And real quickly, Alvin and the Chipmunks. What is going on there?
Were you on that gig, Bill? Were you Theodore?
Or? He's not claiming
no.
it.
No.
That doesn't ring a bell. Of course, I could have been.
Yeah, I actually did work with Alvin and the Chipmunks. It was, I think it was maybe IBM had a big picnic for all of their employees upstate New York, and it was in the middle of summer. It was about 100 degrees outside, and we were playing. I was in a band, and we played for these three, what's the proper term? These three little people were wearing chipmunk costumes, just broiling to death when they were kind of like, you wouldn't say lip syncing, they were body syncing to this this recording, and I felt really bad for them because I was sweating my butt off and just sitting in a suit, but they were in these chipmunk costumes, and I hope they're okay.
So it's actually a horrible story. I had no idea I was asking you to tell a horrible story. Wow. Well, I can't tell you what a delight it is to have you three fellows here. And it's so, like I said at the beginning, one of the things I love about this format is it's so conversational. You really can just see them and hear them tossing things back and forth. Gosh, it is really a delight. So thank you all for doing that. And thanks to you for coming out and, again, supporting live music. Please don't go anywhere. There's an entire another set coming up. But I wanted to get a little bit of time to chat with these fellows. By the way, before we let them take a break, anybody have any questions out there? Yes.
First, Bill, you probably have heard this, but your singing reminds me of Joe Williams.
Wow.
I agree. I totally agree.
Good Lord. Well, sure. When I was 10, the Beatles hit town, so I had to have a guitar, like everybody else. So I got a guitar, and a couple of years later, when I was 12, when the first year I could get into school band, I started playing alto saxophone. I was in band, I guess, and then by the time I was about 15, there were some older guys that I started playing tenor sax with in bands, and we played, you know, soul music and stuff. Played, rehearsed three times a week, played for dances. I was still playing guitar, you know, too. And then when I got into college, something happened there. I had started playing flute a little bit in high school and using saxophone fingering and totally not knowing what I was doing. But, you know, Jethro Tull, you know, so I was doing that. And which is one of my favorite bands, by the way. If you ever got to see them live back in the day, oh, man, really amazing. But anyway, I digress. I got into college, and the saxophone teacher, let's just say that we didn't hit it off very well, so I started studying flute, classical flute, in college, and I became a flute major and music ed major too.
Wow.
And then somewhere along the line in college, I started playing clarinet a little bit, and then, like I say, I mean, over the years, I started accumulating more and more horns, and you know, if you're kind of a working pro on the scene, you have to have all the clarinets, you got to have all the saxes. And flute and piccolo and, you know, alto flute, you'll get called to do that sometimes. And so that's, and then guitar, I've just kind of kept up with that. And I taught middle school, well, actually beginner 4th through 8th grade band for about 20 years, just up until last year. Mm. And so, you know, I started playing drums a little bit and playing the bass and just with the kids, you know. And so that's really about what the whole story. I taught at a school called Oak Grove School, which is near Libertyville. It feeds into Libertyville High School, which is where I live. And but it's in a neighboring community called Green Oaks.
Where did you grow up?
Memphis.
Did you?
Mm-hmm.
I think your voice is such a wonderful speaking voice as well as seeing you. Well, radio.
Exactly.
Well, you're very, thank you. You're very kind. Thanks so much. Again, it's an honor to be here and have you all listening to us. It really is. It's our thrill. Thank you. Thanks so much. So,
thanks again, folks. Take these little table cards with you, but please, please stick around. Please stick around. And thanks, Jeremy Kahn, Larry Kohut, Bill Overton, and thank you.
picture.
See, I'm a big
fish sticks and
hey, folks, thanks much for sticking around. These guys are getting ready, and while they are, I'll just remind you, please do take these little table cards with you if you like. They will tell you what's coming up. And I will be here myself next week thank you. I'm actually here every week, but I will be here behind the piano next week with my good buddy Don Sternberg and Jim Cox on the bass, so it should be a good time. And what else? The rest of the month looks actually really good. This is not that tonight isn't fabulous, but we're Paul Marinaro is coming back, and then at the end of the month we've got Judy Roberts and Greg Fishman coming back with a feature called Swinging Couples. It's Judy and Greg and Russ Phillips and Jeannie Lambert, another wonderful singer, and oh look, there's a band behind me. Let me get out of the way. Thanks a lot, folks. And oh, you know what? I was gonna readjust this just a little bit.
Oh, am I? Should I? I'll just move to where I'm supposed to be.
No, I will do it. I'll show you.
Where am I defaulting?
It's actually not you. It's that I'm getting a lot of Bill in this. So I'm actually going to come at it. I think maybe a little bit.
That's cool.
Like that.
Bill, what's our first?
Johnny, come wait. We're going to start out with a Billy Strayhorn tune, Johnny Come Lately. Thank you. Billy Strayhorn. Oh, yeah. Wow. What a human being.
I'm telling you, man.
Who knew?
No kidding. We're going to do a Rube Bloom song for you with lyrics by Johnny Mercer called Day In and Day Out.
This is also balanced.
You're messed up key. Right?
What a fuck.
Oh, man.
Want to give me like the last?
Here, eight, identify. Last eight. Mm-hmm. Sharp four. Math is hard.
Can't you see it's love? One, two. I want two, three.
Follows me about, that same old pounding in my heart whenever I think of you. And darling, I think of you day in and day out, day in. I needn't tell you how bodies begin. Morning with a tingle, one possibility in view, that possibility of maybe seeing you. Come rain, come shine, I see when to me the day is fine. Then I kiss your lips and the pounding becomes the ocean's roar, a thousand drums. Can't you see that it's love? Can there be any doubt? When there it is, day in, day out. Thank you. day in, day out. The same old hoodoo follows me about. That same old pounding in my heart whenever I think of you. And darling, I think of you day in and day out, day out, day in. I need not tell you how my days begin. I wake each morning with a tingle, one possibility in view, that possibility of maybe seeing you. Oh, come rain, come shine, I meet you, and to me the day is fine. Then I kiss your lips and the pounding becomes the ocean's roar and a thousand drums. Can't you see that is love? Can't there be any doubt when there it is, day in and day out? Can't you see that is love? Can't there be any doubt when there it is, day in, day out? She baby baby.
Thank you. That was fun. Rube Bloom and Johnny Mercer.
Man, oh man. I'm telling you.
More great human beings. Oh, wow.
Yeah, well, I'm Robert.
Don't you love the vibe of this place? It's great, man. It's a wonderful thing. I'm just going to set up a cot back here, I think. Just stay here all the time. We're going to do a Cole Porter song for you now, called Dream Dancing.
Oh, dirty beats. Larry in a corner.
Yeah, I kept this all a secret now until you said you
can we play this down a whole step?
No.
And it's seven.
Oh, so just down there, letter A.
No verse, huh?
Latin. One, two, a one, two, three. Thank you. dancing. We're going to do, let's see. This is a song by Pete DeRose, and this was on off of the, or they did this on the Johnny Hartman, John Coltrane album. It's called Autumn Serenade.
Autumn with her serenade, melodies, the sweetest music ever played. Kisses we knew were beautiful souvenirs. As I paused to recall, the leaves seemed to fall like tears. Silver stars were clinging to an autumn sky. Love was ours until October wandered by. As the years come and go, I'll still feel the glow. The time cannot fade when I hear that lovely autumn serenade. through the trees comes autumn with her serenade melodies, the sweetest music ever played. Autumn kisses we knew were beautiful souvenirs. As I pause, recall the leaves seem to fall like tears. Silver stars were clinging to an autumn sky. Love was ours until October wandered by. As the years come and go, I'll still feel the glow. The time cannot fade as I hear that lovely autumn serenade.
A couple more for you. We're going to do a Joe Henderson tune now that's really a blues but kind of has some altered things going on called Isotope.
Yeah. All right, we'll get some chemists here.
Every gathering needs a good chemist, I always say.
Thank you.
Thank you. Play one more song for you, and we really again appreciate so much you all coming out and hearing us, listening, and it's just a fabulous experience for us. We hope you guys had a lot of fun, and thank you, Steve, for having us in and having us here every Thursday. This is just a regular place to come and hang, you know. So this is great, and thanks so much for coming out. We're going to do a Fats Waller song for you. And this one is called Black and Blue. We just sort of wing in this one, but we think you'll like it.
Playing, singing, tap dancing, juggling?
Yeah, I have a plate spinning thing that I'm going to do now.
You got a key? It's a good tune for it.
How about
A minor?
No, can we do it in G minor?
Sure.
Just right now? One, two, one, two, three.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Jeremy Kahn, Larry Kohut, Bill Overton. What a fantastic, fantastic night.
Thank you.
Ta-da! Thanks so much, gentlemen. What a great, great evening. And thanks to all of you for sticking around. I hope you have a great 4th of July, and thanks to these fine gentlemen for making it a wonderful kickoff to the holiday weekend. And you all get gold stars for sticking around to the very end, so thanks a lot. See you back here next week if you care to. I'll be here next week with my trio, and great stuff coming up to the end of the month. Take those table cards with you if you like, and have a great and happy, safe 4th.